The military ambition of China is growing day in and day out. The Chinese growing military is cause of concern for several nations, the USA, Japan, India, and the other ASEAN nations in that region. China is looking to grab the land in any directions of the world by using their debt trap policy called Belt and the Road Initiative. They are also invading the waters of the South China Sea by using their massive navy power. They are sending the troops to the Indian Eastern Ladakh and the fighter jets on the skies of the democratic nation called Taiwan. Now Beijing has stepped up its hypersonic missile program, is seen as a military threat in the Indo-Pacific region. Although their hypersonic dream was diverted by the miles when they tested it, because their hypersonic missile missed the target by the miles, that is why their hypersonic dream was diverted. Two countries, USA and the Japan, expressed their concern regarding the China's effort to undermine the rule-based order. Both the Chinese and the North Korea is the Achilles heel for the USA and the Japan. And Japan and the USA have agreed to collaborate in the research and the development of future technologies while paying the close attention to the advanced space systems, and they are also trying to thwart the threats posed by the hypersonic missiles from both of these countries. The agreement was announced by the Anthony Blinken and the US Secretary of State, and the Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin met the Japanese Foreign Minister Yoshimasa Hayashi and the Defense Minister Nobukishi on January 6. These two countries are trying to come up with something which no one ever came up with. And this new agreement was done keeping North Korea's so-called hypersonic missile test, because North Korea have recently tested the hypersonic missile called the Haoshong 8. What is Haoshong 8? How it work? According to the North Korea state media, the Haoshong 8 is a short-range ballistic missile equipped with a maneuverable re-entry vehicle. The missile's warhead is hypersonic and can fly at a speed above Mach 5. However, it is not clear if the weapon is hypersonic, as it is a ballistic missile, because the ballistic missiles and the hypersonic missiles completely work on the different principles. Ballistic missiles which launched their warheads on unguided but the straight trajectories. The Haoshong 8 is a re-entry is believed to be able to change its directions while it is in flight. Besides, these North Korean missiles are not the hypersonic one that they actually told. North Korea does not have the space program, the advanced space program, and they do not have the supersonic technology too, because the supersonic technology only belongs to the some of the limited countries like the India, Russia, sometimes USA, and the other countries. Other Western countries do have the supersonic technology, but how they have developed the scramjet and the ramjet engine to achieve the hypersonic technology, and how they have acquired that kind of technology, that is the concerns over here. Who gave them those technologies? If someone have not gave them, then how they have developed those technologies, because their R&D program is not so developed. And that question remains. The USA is concerned about this technology because their third missile's defense systems would fail to protect their allies in the Pacific region, because the USA have a South Korea and the Japan, and the South Korea and the Japan is the protectorate under the USA, and the USA is responsible to protect the South Korea and Japan. That is why the USA have installed the third missile defense systems in both of these countries. If these countries having the hypersonic missile program or technology and hypersonic missiles itself, then the third would not be sufficient to protect these countries. So this is the main cause of concern for the USA. In the additions to the North Korea, The USA is concerned of the China's growing hypersonic threat. Maybe China is not very much threatful to the South Korea and the Japan, but the China is the main concern for the USA. The China has been constantly making advancement in its hypersonics weapon technology. The China's accomplishments in the field of hypersonic technology involves the software that is capable of helping in landing the aircrafts and drone which travels at an hypersonic speeds and calibrates the test on meter class hypersonic aerodynamic wind tunnel. The Beijing has also developed an advanced engine manufacturing process for hypersonic projectiles. One of the recent developments in the field is the testing of a fractional bombardment system. A fractional orbital system is one in which a vehicle enters the orbit but comes back to Earth before it entirely circles the planet. However, the China's fractional orbital bombardment systems is believed to be particularly innovative and is known to have been frequently broadened for incorporating concepts that can conduct one or more revolutions. This has left the USA worried over the potential consequences of hypersonics weapons of such sort. After challenge from the China and the Russia, the US renewed the work in this field, in this hypersonic field and the other fields, which they stopped in the early 2000s. But why the USA stopped this kind of technological programs after the 2000s? Because in 1991, the Soviet Union disintegrated. That is why the bigger threat for the USA, the Soviet Union, is no longer over there. That is why the USA stopped this kind of advancements in making those technologies, because they felt that if the Soviet Union is not there, then what is the meaning of carry on, or what is the meaning of spending the money in those technologies that we will not going to use in the future? But the future has changed now. They have to come up with those kind of technologies now. Now, what is the Japan and the US agreement? Now we will going to talk about the USA and the Japan. Both these countries have not shared the details of their agreement. Though whatever the agreement they did, they have not shared the details with the world. The joint statements at the end of their meeting said that the ministers committed to pursue the joint investment that accelerated the innovations and ensured the alliance maintains its technological edge in the critical and the emerging fields, including artificial intelligence, machine learning, directed energy and the quantum computing. One of the most concerned outcomes of this meeting was that both of the countries decided to carry out a joint analysis to figure out the best way to cooperate on building the counter hypersonic technologies. This deal is kind of an AUKUS security agreement that the US did with Australia and the UK, which was also seen as a response to the China. So, the American dream is going beyond the hypersonic, something more advanced, which is beyond the hypersonic means the something more advanced. The USA is also tried their best to think ahead of the time, the ahead of the world. But they stopped thinking after the disintegrations of the Soviet Union. Now they have renewed their thinking. But in the recent scenario, the USA fails to measure the hypersonic water because these countries have already tested their hypersonic capabilities. The Russia have tested the avant-garde missiles, which is an hypersonic missile. They showed the world that the how it work. The world have to believe that the how it, how, the, whether they have the technology or not, the Russia have. Clearly and the decisively, the Russia and the China way ahead of the USA, at least in this case, at least in this making of this technology. That is why they are looking at their all weather technological giant Japan. The USA is looking at the Japan to develop something which is more advanced than the hypersonic technology, because Japan has already tested the rail gun to stop the hypersonic missiles. I think the USA and the Japan is also wants to test the water of the railgun, then how it will going to stop the hypersonic missiles? So now the question section. The first question is, which organization developed crystal blade technology for aero engine? First is DRDO, second is ISRO, third is HAL, fourth is Lockheed Martin. The second question is, Indian Navy conducted PASEK exercise along with which country? The first one is Sri Lanka, second one is France, third one is Indonesia, fourth is Japan. If anyone have any concern or want to ask me any questions, then you can go through my email address, which is twin.power.academy@gmail.com. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.